Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you all remember what we did yesterday. Just give me a second. Yes. I had put up on the group that you all were supposed to do your homework. You all were just supposed to repeat the division sum that we had discussed yesterday. Just as a part of revision, I'll be redoing that sum, right? Last time, one of the students was helping us. Today, I'll just do without anyone's help. Just so that the steps are very clear. And then there are four more sums. For that, I'll take your help. Okay? So let me just take this. Okay, now, if I just revise that part, when I'm dividing 9 and 37, if 9 is in the numerator and 37 is in the denominator, we have to write it like this. You have to remember that the numerator comes inside, right? I hope nobody will write 37 divided by 9. This is wrong. Correct? Many people make this mistake. I hope y'all will not make the same mistake. Okay. Continuing the sum, I told y'all that if 9 is smaller than 37, obviously 37 ke table mein 9 will not come. So what we will do is, whenever this number is smaller, we'll put a 0 and decimal on top. And if I put a decimal on top, I can add a 0. For the first decimal, we can add 0. And then we'll check, okay, 37, how much are 19? If we check the table, 37 ke table mein, we do not have 19. So we can obviously go for something smaller than 90. So here, if you notice, this is 111. This is greater than 90. So I'll go for 74. So I'll say, 2s are 37, 2s are 74. I'll subtract, and if I subtract, I'll get 16. Right? Again, 16 is smaller than 37, so I'll add one more 0, but now I don't have to put a decimal because the decimal is already there. Then again, I'll search for 160 over here. 160 is not there, but I cannot go for more than 160. I cannot go for 185. I have to go for less than 160. So I'll go for 148. 37, 4s are 148. So I'll write 4s are on top, quotient. I'll write 148 here. And if I subtract this, I'll end up getting 12s. Right? Continuing in the same manner, again, 12 is smaller than 37, so I'll add 10. And when I add a 0, this becomes 120, so I'll search for it over here. Here, if I check, 148 is greater than 120. So I'll go for 111. 37, 3s are. So I'll write 3 here. 111. And if I subtract this, I end up getting 9. And what I notice is I get the same number I started with. So if I put 0 here, it will become 90. And then this entire thing will keep repeating. And this is what we had discussed last time. That whenever we have a rational number, I hope everyone remembers the definition of rational number that we discussed yesterday. I'm not saying natural, okay? I'm saying rational. The definition for rational number is integer upon integer. So if we have rational, that is integer upon integer, obviously the answer can either be terminating or it can be non-terminating recurring. So tell me, if this is not stopping, but if you notice the same 2, 4, 3 will repeat again and again. So if I give you two choices, what is this? Is this terminating or is this non-terminating recurring? What do you all say, students? Is it terminating or non-terminating recurring? I hope all of you all are answering that it is non-terminating recurring because it is not going to stop. This 243, 243, 243 will keep repeating and we can convert it to a smaller format, that is this way. You can present it with a bar on top. Right? This is how we can write it. I hope you all tried the sum at home and you all got the same answer. So if you all did, I think we can again try a similar sum like this and let's see if we can get the right answer or not. Okay, the next sum that we'll be discussing. Yes. So the next sum that we are discussing from practice set 1.3 is sum number 3. I'm skipping 2. I'll get back to 2 soon. Let us do this sum now. 9 divided by 14. And obviously, as discussed earlier, if we do not know the table of 14, it makes more sense to write down 14 ka table on the right side so we can take that help how we did in the previous one. So let me check. I want to see how many of you all know the table of 14 by heart. You all can raise your hand or you all can message me. And I'll pick one of you all to help me out. I want to see out of so many students, how many of you all know the table of 14? And if till now you all do not know, I would suggest that you all should know thoroughly the table from 1 till 19. That will make your calculations very easy. Okay? Okay, fine. What I'll do is I'll pick out of the raised hand, I'll pick one of the persons. Let me pick Shubhra Savant from DN Nagar. Hello, Shubhra. I'm trying to unmute you.
Hello, sir. Hello, sir.
Ah, yes. Shubhra, you can hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I want you to tell me the table of 14 so I can write it down. So students who do not know can use that as a guide, okay?
14
with
the 14.
Very good. Then?
14 to the 28.
Yes.
14 threes are 42.
Okay.
14 fours are 56.
Right.
14 fives are 70.
Right.
14 sixes are 84.
Correct.
14 sevens are 98.
Right.
14 eights are 112.
Right.
14 nines are 126.
120. This is all we need for division. Okay. Nice work, Shubhra.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay. So now I have noted down the table of 14. Now let me pick someone who's not raised their hand to help me with the division. Right? Like how one of the students that helped me yesterday. Let me go for Manmeet from Sai Dham. Hello, yes, Manmeet. Yes. You'll help me with division today?
Okay, sir.
Okay. What I'll do first is I'll give you two options. Option A and option B. You tell me which is the correct one. Okay?
Yes.
Which is the correct one?
Sir, first.
First one, option A.
Yes.
Because numerator should come inside, correct? Okay, let's start with that then. Yes. Tell me, what should I do first?
14, 0. 0.
0. Very good. 0 then?
Decimal.
Sorry?
Decimal point, sir.
Decimal point. Okay. After decimal, what should I do?
90.
90. Okay.
Then now 6 is 84.
Very good. 6 are 84. So 6 are 84. Whatever, subtract and check what it is.
Hello?
Hello?
So 6.
6. Very good. Okay. Then what do we do?
It will become 60.
60. Just 1 second. Okay. Okay, students, while we are discussing, you all should also be doing the sum. So I hope when we are doing it, you all are trying to be ahead of us. Right? Let's continue. Yeah. After 60?
14 fours are 56.
Yes, 14 fours are 56. So I'll put 4 here. 56. Subtract this.
4.
4. Okay. 40. Then?
It will become 40.
40. Okay.
14 twos are 28.
Very good. 14 twos are, so I'm writing twos are 28. Okay, subtract this.
12.
12. Okay, very good. Then?
Then, zero.
Zero.
14, 8's a 112.
Very good. 8's a 112. Okay, subtract this.
8.
8. Then?
10.
0.
5's a 17. 70. 14, 5.
5's a 70, yes. After this?
10.
10. Achha, Manvi, should we keep continuing or should we stop?
So you can continue.
Till when should we continue?
Till the new number. So till that number matlab,
till something repeats.
Yes.
Correct? Yes. Till now you have nothing has repeated. Okay, 10. 10 ke baad?
100.
100.
7's a 98.
7's a 98. Okay. Subtract this.
2.
2. Then?
20.
20. Okay.
1's a 14.
1's a 14. After this?
60.
6 pehle aayega na? Then we'll make it 60.
Yeah,
okay. 14, after that?
4's a...
Don't you think we should stop now?
Yes, sir. 1 is... 4 is repeating now.
What is repeating? Yes. No, no. Look at it this way. Isko dekhna chahiye. We shouldn't look at these numbers. Can yes. you see 60 was coming here?
Yes, yes.
Now 60 has come again.
Yes.
So itna part hai na wapas niche repeat hoga. So if you go to do this, this entire thing will keep on repeating.
Yes.
Correct? That means what I notice here is ye wala part repeat nahi ho raha. Right?
Yes.
What is repeating? What is going to repeat is from this part. 4, 2, 8, 5, 7, 1. Wahan se repeat hoga. So when I write the answer. See, I'm writing the answer below. 9 divided by 14. Okay. I'll write 0.6428571. Now, remember I taught you how to put dots and bars for repetition?
Dot on each number and a bar to the whole number.
Achha. What we'll do is, dekho, generally in textbook, dots follow nahi karte hain. So, we'll follow only bar.
Yes.
Okay. So tell me, bar कहाँ से start होना चाहिए? 6 से start होना चाहिए या 4 से या 2 से या 8 से? कहाँ से bar start करें?
Sir, full 0 point.
0 से लेके यहाँ तक?
Sir, no, from 6.
6 से लेके यहाँ तक?
Yes.
No, that is wrong. Do you notice ये 90 नहीं repeat हुआ था? देखो, ये जो part है ना, this has not repeated. Where is the repetition starting from? Here. So, आपको याद है 14, 4's are 56 हम लोग ने लिखा था.
Yes.
तो जब यहाँ पे वापस हम लोग लिखेंगे, 14 6's are लिखेंगे या 14 4's are लिखेंगे?
4's are.
तो सिर्फ ये पार्ट रिपीट होते जाएगा ना 428571, 428571, 428. क्या 6 रिपीट होगा?
No, no.
तो do you think 6 के ऊपर बार आना चाहिए या 4 से स्टार्ट होना चाहिए?
From 4.
Did you understand the difference?
Yes, sir.
I hope the you are understanding everything, okay, Manmeet?
Yes.
Okay, but you answered beautifully. Thanks a lot.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Yes, I'm muting you now.
Yes.
Yes, students, I hope everyone has understood what we discussed right now. Right? And I hope when we are doing the sum, you all are doing it with me. Sirf dekhne ke liye, we are not coming for these online lectures. We are coming so that we can try. And then if you make mistakes, we learn from what I am doing. That is why we are going very slowly. I'm taking someone's help. Right? Okay. Let's try a few more sums. Another one that I'm going to try is the fifth one now. Okay. Okay. So here, the only problem that some people might see is the minus is there. Now, yesterday I taught you all a rule. Jab minus ko hum log discuss kar rahe the fraction mein, I told you all that minus should never be in the denominator. it should either be in between or it should be with in the numerator. So ye to rule follow kar raha hai. But division mein this might lead to confusion. So my suggestion is, when you all go to divide, forget minus. Divide the full thing without minus, or end mein answer mein minus dal dena. ठीक है, सो दैट इट डज नॉट अफेक्ट अ डिविजन मेथड. लेट्स गो नॉर्मली विद इट. एंड अगेन, इफ यू नोटिस हियर, हियर वी विल रिक्वायर द टेबल ऑफ 13. सो रेज योर हैंड्स क्विकली टू शो मी हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू ऑल नो द टेबल ऑफ 13. आई होप मोर पीपल नो 13 का टेबल एज कंपेयर टू 14. एंड फॉर स्टूडेंट्स हू डू नॉट नो, दिस इज अ साइन. वी हैव अ लॉकडाउन गोइंग ऑन राइट नाउ. This is a good time to make sure your tables are sorted. This will make your 9th and 10th very easy. Right? So, pura 8th aapke paas hai. Make sure aap log acche se tables learn kar lo. Okay, let me pick someone from Vikroli now. Okay, Krishna. Let's try Krishna from Vikroli. Hello, Krishna.
Yes, sir.
Yes, आप 13 का टेबल बताओगे?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm writing it down. 13 ones are
13.
Yes, continue.
13 twos are 26.
Okay.
13 threes are 39.
Yes, very good.
13 fours are 52.
Correct.
13 fives are 65.
Right.
13 sixes are 78.
13 sevens are 91. Okay. 13 eights are 104. 13 eights are 104. And last?
13 nines are 117.
Very good. Aapko kahan tak aata hai tables?
19
tak. Very good, very good. Theek hai. Thank you, Krishna.
Thank you.
I'll pick someone for division. Okay, let me check. Okay, let me try Hitesh from Parla.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you'll have to help me with division. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Achha, now tell me here, when I'm writing the division, inside, should I write 13 or 11?
सर
11. अच्छा, माइनस का मैंने क्या करने बोला है?
सर वी शुड अवॉइड इट एंड एट द लास्ट वी शुड
राइट
मेंशन इट.
ओके, सो हियर ऑब्वियसली 13 आएगा. ओके, नाउ स्टार्ट. व्हाट शुड आई डू फर्स्ट?
जीरो.
ओके, जीरो, देन
पॉइंट.
पॉइंट,
यस, एंड 110.
वेरी गुड, 110. Then?
Now, 8s are 104.
Very good. So, 13 8s are 104. Okay, subtract it. 6. Then?
60.
Very good, 60. Then?
4s are 52.
Okay. 4s are 52. Then, iska subtraction?
8.
8. Then?
80. 6 are 78.
Okay, 6 are 78. The subtraction?
2.
2.
20.
20.
1s are?
1s are. 1s are?
13.
13. Then subtract?
7.
7.
70.
70.
5s are 65.
5s are 65. Okay.
5. 5. 0, 50. 50.
3s are 39. Okay. 3s are 39. 30. Subtract this.
11.
11. Then?
Sir, we should stop now.
Acha. Because this thing will repeat over here again.
Yes.
Correct? तो यहाँ पे इफ आई टू राइट द फाइनल आंसर माइनस 11 अपॉन 13 है, राइट? आई विल जस्ट फर्स्ट आई विल कॉपी दिस.
यस.
तो 0.846153. अच्छा, बार डालना पड़ेगा या बार नहीं डालना पड़ेगा?
सर डालना पड़ेगा बार।
अच्छा, और बार डालेंगे तो कहाँ से स्टार्ट करूँ? 8 से 4 से? The entire thing will repeat, no? Because yes. repetition has happened from here, so this full thing will repeat.
Yes.
So bar I'll put on top. Acha, one thing we are forgetting. Can you tell me what it is?
The sign of subtraction.
Yes, because minus is here.
Yeah.
So negative sign. Correct.
Yes.
Okay. Thanks a lot. You answered very nicely.
Welcome, sir.
Okay. Fine, we are very close to finishing the exercise, everyone. There are only two more sums left. So let's continue. Okay. Next one that we'll be going for is the fourth sum. Okay. I'll take it here. Fourth sum, again, if you notice, there's negative there. Minus 103 upon 5. Correct? Okay, what I'll do is I'm not going to divide it. I want you all to divide it and tell me quickly what the answer is. I want all of you all to try and I want to see who's the first one to answer. Message me aapke answer mereko bata do. Okay, this I'm not going to take anyone's help. I want everyone to solve this quickly and I want to see who answers this first. Okay, I can see Amberlyn D'Souza from JB Nagar has answered it first. And she's answered it correctly. Very good. Still, I can still take more answers. Some people are answering it wrong. Right? I can see mistakes. I'm not going to tell you the answer till I see a lot of messages coming. I still want to see more people. I want to check. Many people are making many mistakes. Swayam Vora, it's not the correct answer. Yes, Hariya from Ghatkopar is correct. Swayam Vora, your answer is wrong. Himani, your answer is wrong. Just check what mistakes you all are making. Mehak from Saidham, your answer is not correct. Nishita, it's not right. Param Doshi, you're forgetting a very small thing in the answer. Rachel also, it's not right. Rachel from JB Nagar, just check your answer again. Manmeet has made a small mistake. Right? Okay, fine. Okay. So since a lot of people have answered, let us just check what the mistake must have been. And for such a sum, I'll even give you all a small trick to do a sum where we are dividing by 5. Okay. Okay. So let me just divide it here. Firstly, as I told you, we'll forget minus for now, but answer mein minus aana chahiye. But for now, let us not look at it. Let me take 103 and try it divided by 5. Here obviously 103 is bigger than 5, so I don't need to start with decimal. First digit is smaller than 5, so for now I take two digits together. 5, how much is 10? So 5, 2s are 10. Right? If I subtract it, I'll get 0. Right, everyone? Here what I'll do is, when I borrow 3 down, if you notice, when I borrow it down, jab main pehla borrowing le raha hun, it is still smaller than, see, 0 is smaller than 5. Theek hai. When I took 3, also that is smaller than 5. Since this after borrowing also is smaller than 5, I'll have to take a 0 over here. Okay, many people forget this. And then I'll put a point. You should understand, maine dekho pehle 3 borrow kiya. After subtracting, if I got 0, that was smaller than 5. नहीं चला फिर मैंने 3 को बोरो किया दैट इज आल्सो आफ्टर बोरोइंग इट इज स्मॉलर सो आई हैड टू पुट अ जीरो हियर देन आई पुट अ डेसिमल Then I put a zero here, so it becomes 30. So 5, 6 are 30. If I minus it, it becomes zero. So it's terminating. Can you see the remainder is zero? That means iske aage nahi badh payenge. So it is terminating. And I saw many people were answering 20.6, but they were forgetting the minus. Answer mein minus aana zaruri hai. Right? Okay, for this I told you, I'll give you all a trick also. So I'll quickly discuss the trick with you. Okay, for the trick, you all should know a very basic thing. I'll just explain it here for now. Let us say the question was 103 upon 10. Okay, if the question was 103 upon 10, then rather than dividing these two, there's a very easy way. If denominator mein there is one zero, I do not need to divide. All I need to do is shift the decimal. If someone does not understand it, it's okay. You all can go for the normal method. But this I'm only helping you all so that you all can check the answer. Tum log check karoge whatever you all got was correct or not. So understand this part properly. If there is zero, sorry, there's 10 or there is 100 or there is 1000 in the denominator, division becomes very easy. If denominator has 10, then see, decimal is technically here. Remember I told you 5 is actually 5.0. वैसे 103 is 103.0. तो पॉइंट इधर है. And if 10 से डिवाइड हो रहा है, the decimal shift backwards. If I'm dividing it by 10, the decimal shift पीछे. That means the decimal will come from here till here. And the answer will become 10.3. You understood how I divided this? I did not have to do this. I just did a simple trick. If when I was dividing it by 10, I just shifted the decimal. But here 10 is not there. So for that, I'm giving you all a simple trick. Just see if you all understand it. Denominator mein there is 5. 10 is not there. But think, can I make this 10? Can I multiply by some number? And can I make 5 into 10? Because 10 will make it very easy for me. 5 ko kya multiply karunga to ye 10 banega? So the answer is, if I multiply 5 by 2, it will become 10. But one rule in mathematics is, if you make any change in the denominator, that same change has to be made in the numerator. So here also I'll have to multiply by 2. If I multiply 3 niche, I'll have to multiply 3 on top. And when I'll multiply now, if you notice, the answer will be 5 2s are 10. Denominator mein 10 aa gaya. And if you take this aside and multiply, you'll get minus 206. And now if I have to write the answer, all I have to do is, ek zero hai, decimal yahan pe hai, shifted backwards. So what we'll end up getting is minus 20.6. Isn't it the same answer? Right? If someone has not understood, it's entirely okay, because in 9th we will discuss this properly. In 8th, you all have to show this method. I explained it this to you all only so that you all can check, because I saw many students were making mistakes. So just to avoid that, we can check. Agar 5 hai, then we can multiply it by 2 and make it 10. I hope everyone understood that trick properly. I hope all the sums that we discussed today was very clear. I'll be putting the homework on the group, right? But I'll explain to you all also that if you all have the textbook, then the homework is practice at 1.3 completely. Out of that, luckily, you all have already done one sum. Right? You all have already done 9 upon 37. So all you have to do is you all have to do 4 more sums. 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? I'll just write it down for you all. So the homework is practice set 1.3. This is the homework. But out of that first sum you all have done, so you all don't have to do it again. Ek bar agar correct aaya to mat karo, wrong aaya to wapas karna. Right? These are division sums, very basic. And once you all get it correctly, next time again we'll be meeting and we'll be discussing fractions and numbers like this. I hope students, all of you all are understanding these lectures. And I was very happy to see a lot of people were answering. Yes, Rachel, PS stands for practice set. Okay, practice set 1.3. And someone was asking me, is it okay if I do one method? Yes, if you want to do one method, then always follow this method. You don't have to know this. This is just a trick. right? Okay, so what you all can do is you all can do the homework, and whatever doubts you all have, you all can keep it ready. So next time, next week when we meet again, next time we'll be meeting on Wednesday, because last Wednesday we were as we put up on the group, there were some issues, so we did not hold the lecture. We postponed it to Thursday, but next week onwards, we'll again keep the lectures Monday, Wednesday and Friday. Okay. So make sure whichever lectures are happening, you all are going back again, reading through. If sums are being done, you all are practicing it again. Read through the textbook. Understand it properly. See that you all are understanding everything. So that once 8th standard school starts, you all will find studies very easy. Okay. Dhruv sir.
Yes, sir.
Should I stop now or?
Yes, sir. You can leave the meeting.
Fine. Okay. Thank you, students. I'll see you all on Wednesday then. See you.
Thank you so much, Arik, sir. All right, guys. We have another lecture. It's science lecture. And your teacher for science is going to be Nikita, ma'am. Good afternoon, Nikita, ma'am. Ma'am, am I audible to you? I cannot hear you. Nikita, ma'am, if you're saying something, it's not audible.
Hello. Aurik, sir, can you hear me now?
This is Dhruv, sir, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay. I'm sorry, Dhruv sir, yes.
No problems, ma'am. Yeah, ma'am, so we are good to go. You can start.
Okay, thank you so much, sir.